Thank you guys for being here with us today in the celebration of Diana and Ralph Contreras. Woo woo! Sit back, relax, enjoy the show. Yeah, so my mom Diana was born September 14, 1919. So she's a Virgo, and she's also an Earth sign. Ralph was born January 23. He's an Aquarius, and he's an Air sign. Earth signs get along for each other. Earth signs being Capricorn, Taurus, and Virgo. They all get along. They're also compatible with other water signs, which are Cancers, Scorpio, and Pisces. So you must be thinking, oh gosh, Joe, you're already messing up the party. How are they even compatible if one's an air sign and one's an earth sign and they're not compatible with each other and with the elements? Well, here's the thing. Ralph was born off the cusp of Capricorn, and Capricorn ends on January 20th. And because of this, he carries a lot of these Capricorn traits. And he's born under the month of the one and not the two. February is the second month, and Capricorn is the first month. So because of this, he has a lot of these tendencies. And this is why he's very compatible with his wife, Diana. Yeah, his wife, Diana. How does that sound, Ralph? How does it feel? Because of these Capricorn traits within Ralph, this will make the relationship and the marriage long and lasting, because they'll have a lot in common and they'll share a lot with themselves. And these traits within Ralph drew my mother Diana closer to him because of that Capricorn energy. Because Earth signs are very compatible with each other, especially Capricorns and Virgos. And one very strong trait that Ralph possesses, being that he's born off the cusp of Capricorn, is that he's a very hard worker. Capricorns have great work ethics, and they'll work under any kind of condition in order to get to the top, and they always do. Remember, the image that's associated with Capricorn is the goat, and the goat will climb any mountain no matter the condition to get to the top, so you can see it in that aspect. And you know, anybody that knows Ralph knows that Ralph works really hard, you know. He's a workaholic, you know. It don't matter. Rain, sleet, hail, snow, he's out there, you know, doing time and a half, overtime. He may have like 20,000 sick days. He still won't take off, you know. That's just in him. That's his nature, because he has that Capricorn trait. And Capricorns are workaholics. They take their jobs very seriously, and you can see that Ralph takes his job very seriously. And this is something that my mother Diana is attracted to, because she's a Virgo, and Virgos also work very hard. So there's a very good respect there, and she could deal with that. She likes that consistency, that vigor. And being that Ralph possesses these Capricorn traits, and like I said before, Capricorn is all about getting to the top, so they don't like to be stagnant. And with Ralph's work ethic and him working so hard, he did exactly that. And he was promoted not too long ago, about a year or two ago, to a management position where he like manages a new school now, which is good. And it's actually good for the Capricorn traits that he has, because Capricorns make great leaders. You know, they know how to manage. They know how to be on top of things. For example, like Martin Luther King or Muhammad Ali, you know. Also, with these Capricorn traits that Ralph possesses, he knows how to be a gentleman, because Capricorns are known for being gentlemen, and they'll spoil their women to death. So, Mom, you could have whatever you like. Nah, just kidding. But remember, like we said, Ralph is Aquarius. He just has these Capricorn traits. And thank God for that, because whereas Capricorn, if he was a full Capricorn, yes, he'd be loving to his wife, his family, and give to his family, but it probably would stop there, because Capricorns are known for being frugal. But Aquarius, however, are very generous. And anybody knows Ralph, it don't matter if you're family, whatever, you know, he's very giving. You know, he'll let you into his home, you know, he'll break bread with you, he'll share wisdom with you, you know, he won't hold back. And that's an Aquarius trait. They have this humanitarian nature about them, which makes Ralph very calm, actually, and very tranquil, even though he may have these Capricorn traits, because Capricorns could be very intense if they get upset or something like that. Well, whereas Aquarius, though, they know how to be very reserved. And because of this, this makes them very likable and easy to get along with. And with all these positive traits, how can my mother not be swept off her feet and fall in love with him? My mother Diana, being that she's a Virgo, she possesses a lot of these similar qualities. You know, anybody knows Virgos or Earth signs in general, they like to work hard. So it complements him very well, and she'll cater to his needs. She's the type that'll work very hard, get the job done very quickly, pick up the slack of somebody else, and still finish in a timely fashion, you know what I mean? So, being that my mother's a Virgo, This means she's very feminine and possesses a lot of beauty. But however, don't let that beauty fool you at all, because she could be very tough and very strong. And when it comes to Virgo women, they possess this kind of aura or energy that stands out from other women when they're in this group that says that I'm the boss. And anybody that knows my mother, y'all know what I'm talking about. Virgos make really great wives. And I'm not just saying that because you're my mom. It's true, really, it is. You guys know how to cater and you're very generous. And being that Ralph is bringing home the bacon, that should be the last thing I'm talking about, bacon, right? Inside joke for family members only. But when it comes to his hard work, she will not take advantage of that and she'll be very grateful. Remember, the image and symbol that represents Virgo is a woman that possesses wings. These wings represent purity, which can relate that with perfection. Hence is why they say Virgos are perfectionists. And speaking of perfection, I remember specifically when my mom set up for a reception when me and my wife got married. And the way she set everything up, you know, it looked really elegant. The centerpieces and everything, like everything was placed right. And the colors, vibrant. It was like, wow, it was amazing, you know. You could easily pay her like 5-6 G's to set somebody's party up. I always told her like she's against some kind of business like that. Also, when it comes to perfection, she has a really good eye. And when she rocks her clothing, it looks really good on her and it's styled right. And also when it comes to those Christmas gifts and, you know, when we get clothing, like, she always picks out these outfits that if I saw in the store, I wouldn't even think it would go together for me. And then when she buys it and I try it on, I'm like, wow, okay. Styling on them. So, thanks, Mom. Appreciate it. Oh, yeah, another thing that's always on point, the food, the grub. Always something different, something creative, especially the treats, the sweets, the oatmeal cookies with that glaze on top. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. And of course, a lot of that comes from that love too, you know, that warmth. You know, Virgos have a lot of warmth. She has a lot of warm energy about her. So when she prepares her meals, you know, it expresses that taste, that love that you could tell that's coming from the heart. And one thing about my mom, which you guys know about, she's not afraid to speak up and express herself, especially if she's being tested. You know, she'll tell you how it is. And this is because she's ruled by the planet Mercury. And Mercury is a planet of communication and expression. And this planet also rules the sign of Gemini. And you guys know my brother Tim. He's a Gemini. You see how he is. He's very expressive, very humorous, and he can be talkative as well. But in a good way, you know what I mean? So, you know, they say that commonality because of that planet. Earth signs are very grounded, stable, and they could be homebodies. And this complements my mom and Ralph very well. They both make a great team, so when they fuel each other with ideas, there'll be little to no disagreement at all. And a lot of this agreement and cooperation also stems from their birth date. Remember, Ralph is born on the 23rd of January, and my mom is born on the 14th of September. When you look at the birth date specifically with Ralph, 2 + 3 from the 23 is 5. And with my mom, 1 + 4 from the 14 is also 5. So they have this 5 frequency. And this number 5 is all about change and adventure, which is exactly what happened once they got together and hooked up. And one of the big changes they made is that they bought a house together, and this was like 5 years ago. And I remember the first time I seen that house and comparing it to now, like so many changes, so many home improvements went into that house within the last 5 years. I was like, whoa, like when you go into the house now and you see the interior of the house, you're like, whoa, this isn't the same place, you know what I mean? So it's, you know, that change, that frequency, because the number, that vibration, it's always going to want to, you know, do better and be very creative about it too. And also, if both of them being a 5, and this 5 has this adventurous kind of an energy, you know, when you get into the house, you feel this hospitality, you feel all this generosity. And when there's a family gathering, it's always a good time and we have a lot of fun. And one last thing, with both their frequency being a 5, no matter how hard they work, Ralph doing overtime, going to work during bad weather conditions, and mom working 2 jobs. With all that being said, they still manage to make time to go out, have dinner, go on vacations, travel, do road trips, spend time with the grandkids, and go somewhere. And this is the frequency of the 5. You know, 5 always want to travel and change and do something to clear their minds from the hard work so they don't feel so suppressed. You know what I mean? And they can recharge themselves. Hope you guys enjoyed the video and it didn't take too much of our time. We're truly happy to be a part of Ralph and Diana Contreras' celebration. I hope I didn't butcher that last name. Bad things. But like I said, we are truly honored to be a part of this beautiful moment. We wish you infinite happiness and love. May the vows committed in front of God be cherished and not forgotten. May the Lord continue to watch over you both and protect you. Let any stumble, trial, and tribulation be short-lived. And any difficulties you may face, may it just be a lesson to be learned in order to grow and be closer. Remember, pain is temporary and the heart will always beat until the Lord says it's time to sleep for eternity. So while in the moment, cherish it like you won't see tomorrow. And let your heart beat with joy, peace, and love. Forever. Amen.
Everywhere I'm looking now, I'm surrounded by your